Warning, this advice is going to blow your mind. What's up, travelers? How's it going? Welcome to a Writing Wednesday. And welcome to my first ever writing advice video. Now, this is probably going to get a little ranty, but that's because when I wrote it, I was really frustrated, and it doesn't matter how long it's been since something has frustrated me. If I go back to it, I will get just as frustrated. So I was scrolling through YouTube. I was in the WriterTube section of it, and on the sidebar, I saw this video that says how to write male characters. Now, that may not seem like a big deal to some people, but if you ever actually look for writing advice, you don't usually see writing advice that's specific to how to write male characters, or at the very least, I haven't. I'm not gonna name the YouTuber's name, but I clicked on it, and let me tell you how I couldn't even finish it, because it was just, it was not good. Let's see, they start off by saying that the first thing you gotta remember is that men do not bitch. You know, they don't complain. If there's a problem going on at work, you know, you'll never hear about it. And, oh, if you're dating them, you gotta understand that. Even if you're talking about your day, they're not gonna listen to you. You know, they're only gonna catch half of what you're saying and just nod and pretend like they're listening. And, look, there will be some penis people out there who are totally like that. I'm not gonna deny that. But it's not exclusive to the penis. Because there are people out there with vaginas who act just like that. And there are penis people who don't act like that. And there are vagina people who don't act like that. I mean, I know plenty of men who do nothing but bitch about their job. I know plenty of men who listen to their significant other when they're talking to them. Why ask your significant other how their day was if you weren't going to listen to them? That doesn't make sense. And quite frankly, it's just rude. And like I said, I know people with vaginas who do shit like that, and I know people with penises who do shit like that. It's not exclusive to the penis. So now, the YouTubers also made a how to write female character video. And again, I couldn't finish it. It was really cringeworthy. It wasn't accurate. Maybe accurate in their personal experience, but not accurate in reality. I only got through one trait, and they started the trait off as a skit, and they went about, well, Trisha went to her friend's house and she saw a pug, and she got all super excited because for some reason women love pugs. This is a little bullshit to me, because I don't actually know any person with a vagina who likes pugs. Personally, I'm a fan of huskies. My one female friend is a fan of Pomeranians. And then I have another female friend who's obsessed with corgis. And then I have another friend who's obsessed with Dalmatians. I've never heard them be obsessed with pugs, so I don't know where this person got the idea that people with vaginas love pug dogs. And I went, okay, whatever. And I continue on the video, and then the video got to the part where it was, yeah, then Trisha comes home and she's all bitching and complaining about how much she wants a pug now because women love what other women have, or women want what other women have. Okay, the idea of wanting a dog, I find that hard to believe. It comes from seeing another person with a dog. Dogs are fucking awesome. Secondly, I think the only way this can be applied is if it's something that's unique. You can't sit there and say, yeah, going back to wanting a dog because it's a dog. If the thing exists in multiples, wanting it is not a product of someone else has it, because someone else is always going to have it. But if it's something unique and you can't find it anywhere else, then that's one thing. Like, you say there's this single and sad vagina person walking around, and they see this happy-go-lucky couple, and the one significant other is just like the ultimate significant other, and they went, oh man, I want that in my life. But they don't want just any awesome significant other, they want that particular awesome significant other. And that is a matter of being envious and jealous and wanting something somebody else has. Now that works. And again, there are people with vaginas who behave like this. But it's not exclusive to the vagina, because there are penis people who behave like that too.
I don't...
So, again, if you're looking for specific ways to write someone based on their genitalia, my advice is don't. My advice, if you want to know how to write someone who is the opposite sex of you, to just write the character. Because we are individuals, yes. Thanks to culture and society and social construct, we do tend to fall into gender roles from time to time. But not always. So just write an awesome, well-developed character and then worry about what's going to be in their pants. And if you think you messed up, that's what critique partners and beta readers are for. They will catch it for you and they will set you on the right path. Okay? And that's my advice for you. Okay, travelers. Thanks for going on this long trek with me for my first ever advice video. If you like what you see and you want to see more, please feel free to subscribe. And if you want to set the destination for my next video, leave a comment down below. Or you could tweet me at ZanitaD. Bye.